You decide whether it's compelling. I don't want to tell you if it was or not. About his extraordinary highs and also dangerous lows.
He's the original punk turned global superstar. Billy Idol has sold more than 40 million albums in a career spanning four decades. Come on, it's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Billy Idol, welcome back to Australia. 13 years. Why has it taken so long?
That is a good question. Yeah, why do things take a long time? I don't know. Sometimes it's just the way life is. It doesn't go in a straight line. Nothing's linear.
Yeah, absolutely. What a career you've had. You've had huge highs, huge lows. When you look back at it, how would you sum your career up?
Well, I've messed up a lot, but I've had a lot of success too. And in a way, it's balancing out, I suppose. I don't know. Yeah. And leaving me in a position where I can still enjoy doing it. That's one thing. I haven't completely burnt myself out on it, you know, because I did it so much in the past or something. I'm still excited about doing what I do. Yeah. So whatever I've done, if it's led me to feel good about it now, it must be right.
Yeah.
I did a lot of partying and stuff back in the day and stuff, and not even so long ago, really.
Do you look back and say, that's just my makeup. That's what makes me who I am.
Well, I think the thing is, it wasn't just me doing that back then. A lot of us were living a little bit like there was the end of the world. It was just like, because punk rock kind of predicted there's no future. You know, like Johnny Rotten was telling us, there's no future, no future for you. And I think a lot of us took that to heart, really, and you're kind of living as if the world's ending tomorrow and as if it's all going to end in 1990 or something. It was just like that. So you're sort of very living for the moment, and that's what the music was, living in the moment and doing what was right for that time.
Billy says it's always been about the music and always will be. Last year he released his first new album of new material in 10 years and a brutally honest autobiography. You are the rhythm.
What's the one bit of advice you would pass on to emerging rock stars of today?
Be careful what you wish for, because you might just get it. And that's the thing to be a little bit careful about. It was easy to get caught up in the fantasy and let yourself be destroyed by that fantasy.
Any, do you take an interest in any young artists?
Well, my son, actually, Willem, he's got his own group, FIM, and he does his own EDM music as well, his own chill-out music. So, in a way, I've sort of contributed that way, I think.
Do you have a favourite? Huge catalogue, of course, White Wedding, Dancing With Myself, Rebel Yell, the whole thing.
Always love doing Rebel Yell. It's never let me down, not yet, anyway.
It is an absolute classic, isn't it?
It's fantastically good fun to sing, yeah.
Rebel Yell came about by chance, and the incredible origin story involved those other rockers, the Rolling Stones.
It was one of the Stones' birthday parties, and there was Ronnie Wood, Keith Richards and Mick Jagger, and they were all drinking something, and I was sort of like following the label up to see what it was, and I could see this Rebel Confederate officer, cavalry officer, looking a bit like Jeb Stuart or something, with a plume in his hair and obviously galloping, and I could see, it's called Rebel Yell, this drink they were drinking, this bourbon. And I said to them, did you have this stuff made up or something? And they went, because I was fishing already, because hey, Rebel Yell, that's a great title. I love the American Civil War kind of thing. So I sort of sound them out. I said, did you have this stuff made up or something? And they went, no, it's a Southern Sour Mash. And I went, Rebel Yell, God, it's a great title. You wouldn't be thinking about using that, would you? I mean, you've got Street Fighting Man, Jumping Jack Flash.
Yeah.
satisfaction, give me shelter, rebel yell. And they kind of went, thought about it for a second, went, no, I don't think so. And I went,
perfect. Just great songs, aren't
cool
they?
Cool story.
It is a very, yeah.
I like that. I love hearing about that sort of stuff.
It was
random.
Really good to talk to. Mm. Yeah, it was random.
Good just interview. Probing.
Probing. Compelling.
Compelling.
Brutally honest. What other BS can we think of?
Logie Award winning.
All of Billy Idol's tour dates are on the Sunrise website, and he's playing the Vineyards too.
Of course. They all play the Vineyards because, you know, it. That age yep. group.
That young age group.
That young age group.
Our next guest is a music idol of a different generation. Adam Lambert has 5 million Facebook fans.